active and passive.
Welcome back to Paul's Learning Hub once again. Let us continue our class on active and passive voice. I hope all of you enjoyed and understood well about the basic rules and regulations about passive voice from my previous video. Here, let us continue our topic in little bit detail. First of all, let us see the imperative sentences in its different modes.
First of all, let us see imperative sentences expressing order and command. The rule will be like this: let plus object plus be plus third form of the verb. See the example: do this work. It will be changed like this: let this work be done. Similarly, open the door will be changed like let the door be opened. Next, let us see imperative sentences expressing advice. The rule will be like this: object plus should plus be plus third form of the verb. Here we don't use let. For example, love your country will change into passive voice like this: your country should be loved. Similarly, help the poor will change like the poor should be helped. And the next case, imperative sentences with please or kindly. Here we have to use the usage requested to. So the examples you can see: please come in will change into you are requested to come in. Kindly post the letter will change like you are requested to post the letter.
And after this, now let us see what happened to the active tenses which have two objects.
If there are two objects in the sentence, we can use any one of the object as the subject of the passive voice. See the example: she told us a story. Here we have two objects like us and a story. We are going to write the passive voice in two ways. First, we were told a story by her. And second, a story was told to us by her. In both way, we can write. Similarly, see more examples. They appointed him an ambassador. The passive voices: he was appointed an ambassador, as well as an ambassador was appointed to him. And another example: the story has taught to us a good lesson. In passive voices, we have been taught a good lesson by the story, or a good lesson has been taught to us by the story.
And our next topic is interrogative sentences. Already we have studied about the yes or no interrogative, how to convert into passive voice. That is, only we have to replace the first helping verb into the beginning of the sentence. But now here we are going to see about the WH questions, the rules and structure for converting the WH active voice questions into passive voice.
Now let us see how WH questions is being converted into passive voice. First of all, let us see the example: why do they beat you in active voice? How it has been converted into passive voice? Why are you beaten by them? See, the same WH word we have used in passive voice also. And it is followed by helping verb, the object of the active voice, third form of the verb, by plus subject. See another example: what does he eat? In passive, it will become what is eaten by him. And how shall I solve it will change like this: how will it be solved by me? Next, whom will you beat? In passive, whom will be beaten by you? But the questions which begin with who, there will be some different forms. We will get two structures. First one begin with who. It will be followed by be plus object plus third form of the verb plus by. Otherwise, we can write like this: by whom plus be plus object plus verb third. See the example: who opened the door. Either we can write like this, who was the door opened by? Or we can write like this, by whom was the door opened?
Now let us see the case of modal verbs, the active verbs that comes after the modal verbs like shall, will, can, could, may, might, should, would, ought, must, etc. can be used the following structure.
The structure will be like this. Object of the active voice plus modal verb plus be plus third form of the verb plus by plus subject. See the example. She can speak Chinese. In passive, Chinese can be spoken by her. And another example, we must preserve the tiger. In active, in passive, it will become like this. Tigers must be preserved. Now let us bind up with a question. When do we use passive voice? Here, I would suggest three occasions where we have to use passive voice. First one, when the receiver of an action is the emphasis. Second occasion, when it is not necessary to mention the doer of an action. And finally, when the doer of an action is not known or unknown. Thank you for watching Paul's Learning Hub.